All right, back inside the Pirate Radio Zoom Room, brought to you by Sailor Warehouse, your local U.S. Sailor authorized agent. Also, White Claw Hard Seltzer. Nothing tastes quite like it. And your CBD store next to Duck Donuts on Arlington Boulevard. One of the great names in ECU football history. Former Pirate defensive back Rocco Scarfone joining us today. Rocco, how you doing, man?
I'm doing good. I'm doing good. Thanks for having me.
Rocco, we'll talk about your playing days, but let's fill in the blanks from your playing days here at ECU. What have you been up to, and what are you doing currently?
So when I got done playing at ECU, I had an opportunity to go to the CFL, and I didn't do that. I ended up going over to Germany with Shane, and me and Shane played in the German Football League for the Stuttgart Scorpions. And I actually played receiver over there. I know I dropped some interceptions at ECU, but to believe it or not, I did play receiver over there, and it worked out decently. So we had a good time. And then once I got back, I applied to law school. I got into Carolina, and, you know, I kind of switched sides, and I became a Tar Heel.
All right. We don't need to talk about that, Rocco. Let's go back to the Shane Germany part, because we've had Shane on Pirate Radio quite a bit. And from what he said and looking at pictures from Instagram and online, did you guys actually play football, or did y'all just like hang out and party the whole time?
It was a little bit of both. I mean, there was definitely a lot of beers did get drinking. A lot of beers got drank, I guess we should say. You know, we definitely didn't make football like the number one priority there. We made sure that we had fun and then played ball. So we partied hard, but we trained hard too, and we practiced hard and we played hard. But we definitely made sure we got the full experience of being over in Europe. For me, that was my first time. So we made sure to go to Italy, go to the motherland. So it was a good time.
That's awesome. On the Carolina part, we should say that you were telling me before we started recording that you are going to further your law career with a Pirate, right? You had worked with a Pirate last year and are headed back to Florida for that, right?
Well, I'm not working with him, but he kind of is the one that made me want to work in Florida.
Gotcha.
So I worked for Mr. Michael Orr. He's a huge Pirate fan. He's big time Pirate. I mean, in his office, he has a Justin Hardy jersey. He just loves the Pirates. And so I spoke to him, and I worked with him last summer in Jacksonville, Florida, at his firm, Orr Cook. And so I clerked there. And then I got a job at the Palm Beach State Prosecutor's Office.
Awesome. Excellent. Talking to Rocco Scarfone today inside the Zoom room. We'll talk about your playing days, Rocco. Something we've never really talked about publicly. It was the only time a player had walked away from an interview at practice. And I'll tell the whole story as I remember it. So was it was it South Carolina, Rocco?
It was UF, the Florida game.
It was Florida. Okay. On the road. And you had and this is the second time I've brought up a drop pick. We brought up one with Kevin Monroe earlier, so I don't know why I keep bringing the stuff up. You had
it wasn't just one drop pick; it was two back to back. It was two. I'm gonna own it now. I mean, I'm at the place now. I can own it. It was two back to back. Technically, it could have only been one because you can't have back to back picks on separate plays and their own. So, but yeah, it was two back to back.
We had to ask you about it, and I kind of started the questioning and just asked you about that play. You said what happened. You said you dropped picks and you should have caught them. And I think I followed that up with, you know, when something like that happens, how tough is it to kind of get yourself back up mentally, something like that. You answered that fine. And at that point, the media crew all kind of knew, like, all right, now we'll move on to the next game. But another reporter said, and was kind of chuckling. He was like, so what happened?
Yeah.
Dropped the ball? Like, we had already gone over all this crap. From what I remember, Rocco just kind of looked and said, I'm done, and walked off. Is that how you remember it?
Yeah, I mean, you asked me some questions, which were questions that needed to be asked, because, I mean, when you drop the picks that I dropped, I mean, you got to answer for that. I mean, I'm there to make that play. That's what I'm there to do, and I should have made it. And, you know, I owned up to it. I took responsibility because that was no one's fault but mine. And then, you know, I discussed with you about, you know, getting over that hump. You know, right before meeting with you guys, I was at the jugs machine catching balls, staying after to work on that so I wouldn't make the same mistake again. And then he just looks at me sarcastically and goes, so what happened with that? Well, why'd you drop it? And I was just like, dude, are you serious? Like, I just got done answering this. Like, were you not paying attention? And so at that point, I was just like, all right, I'm done, guys. I'll talk to y'all later. And that's when I just walked inside.
And I messaged you after that and kind of apologized on, like, we have to answer ask the question. You have to answer, but you already did. So I was like, man, sorry how that went down. And then I think you yourself even said I should have handled it better. So, like, it was all fine at the end. But it was kind of the only experience I've had like that out there at practice. And, look, you're not a kid, but you're a college kid. You're still learning things. And hell, us reporters never really learn what the hell we're doing anyway. So it was an experience we all kind of learned from, I think.
Yeah, without a doubt. I mean, he just had to take in consideration. I mean, for me, like, I was already getting DMs on Twitter. I was having people at me all the time. Like, my social media after that game got blown up from people just cussing at me, telling me I lost the game. And so I'm dealing with that mentally. Yeah. And, you know, I've already came out, owned up to it. And then to just kind of attack me again with it, that was kind of rude and unprofessional by him. So at that point, I was just like, you know, I'm done with this. You know, I'm not going to put myself in a position to make myself look terrible, even though I probably shouldn't have walked off in hindsight. But, you know, it is what it is at this point. You know, I spoke to you. I spoke to Steve and Igo right afterwards. Both of you guys apologized and understood the situation. So no harm, no foul.
And I think it's important to bring up what you just did about DMs, messages, people going after you. Like, I think for some reason fans think they care more about it than the players do. I don't understand the mindset. Even when I'm cussing at the Redskins on Sundays, I'm not, like, adding Dwayne Haskins. I'm like, frustrated as a fan, but I'm not, like, legitimately mad at a player for screwing up the game. So there is that side of it, man, that only you can speak to because you lived it. So,
yeah, I mean, like, that moment of getting the pick, I had clear grass in front of me. Like, I had envisioned that all summer when I was working out. That was what was in my mind. Florida, I'm going to get a pick six and we're going to win the game. And then it came and it didn't happen. And so, you know, I'm beating myself up mentally because that's a moment that I prepared for. You know, it's like the Eminem song, you're going to catch it or let slip. I let it slip. And so, I mean, like, I already knew I messed up. And so I don't need other people coming and letting me know that I messed up because I'm an intelligent person. I understand what I did. So it doesn't really help anything.
Think about that, fans, when you're watching these games and getting angry. These guys care, and they care more than you do about what they're doing on the field. Let's talk about good times, Rocco. What was your favorite part about being a Pirate on and off the field?
You know, it's got to – nothing stands out specifically besides, I mean, just the brotherhood that was in that locker room. I mean, it was truly like a family. Ruff's not there anymore, but, you know, when he said family, he meant it. I mean, even before my first law school exam, I got a call at, I think it was like 6:45 in the morning. Ruff was on the road to Oklahoma. He saw me tweet about having my first exam. And he called me and said, hey, go check that. Want some, get some. And was just encouraging me on my first exam at 6 a.m., ready to get after it. And, I mean, I hadn't spoken to him for maybe a year or something, and he just calls me out of the blue. And then when he saw that I graduated, he called me again, congratulating me, telling me how proud he was. And he just really lived that family life. And as a team, we were really like a family.
Rocco, you think Mike Houston's the guy for the job here at ECU, trying to turn this ship back around? Do you still keep up with what's happening with ECU football?
Yeah. So I keep up. You know, first, you know, Scotty, he was put in a hard position to me personally. I mean, I know a lot of people have feelings towards Scotty in certain ways. You know, I think honestly, he was put in a position that he couldn't win. He was replacing a coach that everyone loved. And so no matter what he did, it was going to be hard for him to do good. And so he was put in a tough position. I hate it for him. But as far as Mike Houston, I haven't had a chance to actually meet him. But from the way that I've seen that he's running the ship, I like where it's going. You know, he brought in some other Pirates. He brought back Coach Kirkpatrick, which I love that move. He was a good coach back in our day. And I love the fact that he brought back Coach Weaver, Trip Weaver. He was a GA when I was there. And I've been pretty vocal on Twitter the first year he was back about how I wanted Trip back. Trip was a GA for us. And, you know, Tripp has the ability to be – he's one of the best defensive minds I've been around. Him and Damon Magazu are elite defensive minds in my perspective. And so when he came back, I was like, all right, he gets it. He knows what he needs to do, because Tripp does a really good job, not just with X's and O's, but understanding that players have a life outside the lines and knowing how to interact with the guys and make sure that their needs are met on the field and off the field. So I think that was a really good hire for him.
Awesome. Well said. Talking to Rocco Scarfone. Rocco, man, we love to see Pirates leave and do good, and we're glad that you're doing that. And I'd like to say I hope I run into you in Florida, but maybe I don't. I don't want to be in the courtroom, so maybe outside.
You just come down to visit.
Rocco, thanks for hanging out with us today, man, and best of luck in your future.
All right, thank you so much. Thanks for having me, Cliff.
Former ECU DB, Rocco Scarfone, joining us in the Pirate Radio Zoom Room, brought to you by Cellular Warehouse, White Claw Hard Seltzer, and your CBD store. We will see you next time.